Today we're going to work on some SMD LEDs. We're going to solder some different size wires to them, and this is going to be the first time I'm trying this. So we're going to be doing this together. So let's see how this works. Let's go. I'm Tom Kovichak, and this is Tom's Trains and Things. This channel was created to help other modelers who are in need of guidance in pursuing their dream of building a model railroad. And today we're going to work on SMD LEDs, and we're going to solder some wires onto them, some different size wires. Now, I took apart that wall wart, and we're going to try to solder this wire onto it. I haven't really measured it, but I know it's bigger than 30 gauge. So it's somewhere between 22 and 30 gauge. I have some 30 gauge wire right here that I purchased. And from what the manufacturer says, the insulation, the coating on here, you could solder right on it and it works as a flux. So we'll see how that works. It's called Temco MW0071. It's 30 gauge red. And soldered red round copper magnet wire, 155 degrees centigrade. They always give you the reading in centigrade. I wish they'd do something in Fahrenheit, because I hate converting that. Also, we're going to use, I have the green wire. I think this is 22 gauge solid wire. We're going to try some of that. And some red and black. I think this is 20 gauge. I'm not sure. I'll have to check it. But we'll solder some of that on there also. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4 different things that we're going to try to solder on those little SMD. And if you're not familiar with the SMD, in this little package right there, there was 100 of them. And right now I took out 4 of them. I put it on my workbench on a piece of tape so it'll stay connected there so it won't move whenever we try to solder it. I also, in another video and in an upcoming video, we're going to do this type right here. And this is on a little film reel roll. Okay, these are all on a tape together. Now they're divided into threes with a resistor on it. And you could cut it off and use them individually, you know, just the three together. Or you could use the whole thing. I think there's, can't remember what they said, there's 300 LEDs on here. But anyway, that's 300 LEDs on tape, and it's on 3M tape right on the back there. And they give you a little line where you could cut it off and solder your wires onto a little pad on there, like these wires are soldered on right there. So that's in an upcoming episode. So in this one, we're going to work on they're 3.5 by 2.8. SMD LEDs, and I got them through Amazon for about a little under $6 for 100 of them. So that's a pretty good price. And we're not going to worry about the resistors on this one. We're just going to show you how to solder it. This is the first time I'm doing the soldering on those SMDs. So we're going to learn this together. There's a little mark on the face of the LED that I put on here, and it's just a little diagonal. That tells you what the positive and negative side of the LED is, and I lined them all up on. This is the negative side here. This is the positive side right here. Now, what I'm going to do is I'm going to hit these with some liquid flux. Now I put some in a little jar right here, and I'm going to use the liquid on here. just on the soldering pads on the LEDs. Okay, now I got a new soldering station. It's a digital temperature controlled station. Okay, and I've never used these before. I've always used just a regular soldering iron. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to dab a little bit of solder on each one of these pads, and we'll see if I could do this with this iron right here. Okay. And that'll make it a little bit easier to solder the wire on. All right, I'll turn this around the other way. I'm not left-handed, but we'll see how this works. And I'll show you a little bit more about this soldering station in another video. But this is the first time I'm really using it. And this is the first time I'm doing SMD LEDs. This is the 22 gauge green wire right here. And I'm going to put this on here. I'm going to put the wire back this way. And I hope between the two cameras that I'm using, you could see something off of this. Well, my tape isn't holding it very well. I do have it soldered, but it's on there pretty good, but I can always trim off the excess on there. I want to see if the solder is on the way in there. But what I want to do, I'll put this back on here, and I'll come over here, and I have paste over here for the soldering iron itself and for the wire. So what I'm going to do is bring this one over here. And that one went a little bit better. Okay. And the little excess on there I could cut off. Now I'm not going to put resistors on it on this video here. I'm just doing a demonstration for soldering right now. So that was the green wire. This is 22 gauge solid wire. So what we'll do on this side here, I'll just put a little bit more flux on that. I'll put that right there up against it. And I have that one on. Put some flux on here. It's easier for me to do it on the other side than it is on this side here. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to try it like this right here. Okay, now. I got, this is the 20 gauge wire stranded. Take a look at it there. Okay, that's two of them. Now we're going to take some of this magnet wire. I put it off to the side so it would be out of the way. I've never used this before. And I'm just going to take a couple of pieces here, short pieces. And this is 30 gauge magnet wire. And this is what's on the coils, like I did on the thing, on the wall wart. But this is a smaller one than This is a smaller one than what is on the wall wart. Now this one says the insulation on it, that's what the manufacturer says, the insulation on there will be used as flux. So I'll just tip this a little bit and we'll take this and we'll see how right they are. And I'm just gonna bend it just a little bit, put it over here. Not the prettiest thing, but this is the first time that I am attempting this with the magnet wire, and the first time I'm attempting it with the SMD LED. Okay. Now here is the 30 gauge wire. Now that is without stripping anything off of it, and it looks pretty good. What you do on here, I'm going to move this out of the way, is just take your blade and scrape it like this, and then you can use sandpaper or a file to get the excess off of it. I'm going to take that piece, cut it in half, there's one side, and then we'll take this side here. And what I'm going to do is take one of these flat files, and as I'm turning the wire, I'll file on there. Now you could put multiple LEDs on here in your buildings or anything else. They make these LEDs in different sizes. Dip that in a little bit of flux on the pad. Okay. There we go. Next time I'll use a different kind of tape to secure it. Well, it's not the prettiest job, and my hands aren't that steady, but I think we did it, and I think you could see how you could do this. Now, those are good and sturdy on there. So now we have the four different wires. We got 20 gauge solid, or I'm sorry, 22 gauge solid, 20 gauge stranded. We got the 30 gauge magnet wire, and I'm not sure what the gauge this is. This is magnet wire, and you can see that it is a lot larger than 30 gauge. Well, we had three firsts in this video. The first time that I used that new soldering station that I have, and I'll do a video on that coming up pretty shortly. The first time I soldered on those SMD LEDs, they're 3.5 by 2.8 millimeters. And the first time I soldered magnet wires. Now, I've had a lot of experience soldering stranded and solid wires on track, on switches, on a lot of different electronic components, but that was the first time for me for those three soldering experiences right there. It's not too pretty, and I'll show you a couple of graphics back here, but they'll get better. Every time you solder, you'll get a little bit better and they'll look a little bit prettier. What I got coming up, I got another video on feeder wires. I did a video some time ago showing you how to solder feeder wires onto your track and onto bus wire. I have a few more methods that I'm going to show you on another video coming up later on this week. In another episode coming up, I'm going to work on these right here. Now, I got these connectors for the tortoise switch machines, and these are a little bit better than the ones that I already have. And what I would like to do, I'm still trying to look for a little circuit board where I could put these in. I found a board for the RJ45s. This is a breakout board, which I'm going to solder in another video. I'm going to show you how to do that. But what I was hoping to find was another board where, or I might have to have one made. So all this complicated stuff that we have to do. But what I want to do is have these connectors here so I could plug it into the tortoise switch machine. And I think I mentioned this in a couple of other videos, and use the Cat 5 cable from my tortoise switch machine to the control panel. So I just have a little board with these two on there, plug it up in there. I don't have to worry about anything. Just take a Cat 5 cable, plug it in here, and then plug it in on my DS64 where to control my tortoise switch machine. So that's another thing coming up in the near future. It'll probably be in January sometime, because December is kind of full already, and I'm going to be gone for a couple of weeks up to Maryland seeing my children and grandchildren.